Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to continue the discussion on the pathogenesis. So at the beginning of the introduction of pathogenesis, we have introduced that for the pathogenesis, we're going to divide the topic into five categories. The first is the excess and deficiency, which we have introduced in the previous video. And from this video, we're going to discuss the yin and yang impairments. From the first video, the previous video, when we talk about the excess and the deficiency patterns of the disease or of the pathogenesis, we actually focus on the antipathogenic qi and the pathogenic qi. So we actually talk about the struggle between these two kinds of qi, the antipathogenic qi and pathogenic qi. So when they fight together, which part wins can indicate what kinds of phenomena from the clinical practice, what kinds of symptoms can reflect on patients. That's the discussion in the previous video. And from this video, we're going to talk about the yin yang impairments. But first, the yin yang impairment is actually, you see these five categories. We actually only talk about the topic or the objects. We'll be discussing is actually the disease of a patient, the disease of individuals, but as you can see, the disease is actually one disease. But why we use different categories to understand the disease? That's because we see the disease from different way. For instance, if I want to get note of you, so I want to know you more, I will see from your gender. Are you male or female? And then I also might choose to talk to your parents. And then from your parents' side, how your parents see you. What's your parents' opinions on you? And then I also may interview some of your classmates. So from your classmates, how they talk about you. And then I also want to talk to the other lecturers. So they will have their opinions on you as well. And then when you go to work, if you have a part-time job, I want to talk to your colleagues, or I want to talk to your manager at your work, how they look at you from their point of view. So for this example, the object, what I need to do, the aim is that I want to understand you, I want to know you more. But as you can see from the situation, I got different feedbacks. The feedback from your parents, from your classmates, from your other lecturers, from your manager at work, from your colleagues. So I got five different opinions on you, of you. And then these five different opinions are all about you. They might be different. So this is very similar for this pathogenesis, why we use different categories to talk about the disease. That's because we want to understand the disease more completely. And that's why. So from the excess and the deficiency, we understand the disease from the antipathogenic qi and pathogenic qi, the kinds of view. And now we're going to study the view from yin and yang. Yin and yang theory is one of the most important theories in our basic theories of acupuncture, because in future you will know all kinds of situation, all kinds of clinical symptoms. We can categorize them into yin or yang. So when we talk about the imbalance of yin and yang, we also need to understand the characteristics of yin and yang. So yin refers to something darker, static, or negative. Yang refers to brighter, positive, active. So that's the opposite sides of the interrelated objects, interrelated or interrelated substance. So here we discuss the disease, the pathogenesis of disease blood in our body. It actually discuss the process when the disease happens on our human being, and then we see the disease keep developing. While the disease developing, we can see when it develops into yin pattern or yang pattern. That's the contents we're going to study here. And here, although we also use excess or deficiency. So when we talk about excess and deficiency in the previous video, we said that the excess always refers to the pathogenic qi. The excess always refers to the pathogenic qi. The deficiency always refers to anti-pathogenic qi. So that's when we talk about the excess and deficiency patterns. But now in yin and yang theory imbalance, we also use the excess or deficiency. But this excess and deficiency is not only refers to one part of the qi. It can be either part of the qi. The excess of yin or yang. In a broader sense, when we talk about yin and yang actually can categorize all kinds of stuff, even excess and deficiency. In the previous video, we have discussed. But here, we use a more narrow sense of yin and yang. We only refer to the yin and yang itself, because we're going to talk about the zhang fu impairments, the meridians, the four levels in future specifically. So here we only discuss the excess of yin and yang, the deficiency of yin and yang, and also the development or changes of these, the impairment of both yin and yang, how many changes they can have. And although the impairments, meridians impairments, also can be included into yin and yang, but we're going to discuss separately, so we don't include the other information here. The first, we're going to talk about excess of yin and yang. Excess yang refers to the state of our human body become active or pathological active. So the imbalance means pathological. So here we don't talk about the physiology. Physiological situation is the balance. Imbalance means pathological condition. Pathological condition refers to disease stage. So excess yang, it refers to that's the excess stage yang, specifically of yang in our body. What are the symptoms of this? That's just the picture on the right bottom. You can see the baby. The red got the fever, so the body is very hot. And then he might have very heavy breathing. He might have bad mouth smell. So hot fever, when you feel hot, this is the yang symptoms. When you compare with the picture on top, the gentleman lie in the bed and stay quiet, and this is yin pattern. So yang pattern refers to excess yang, but in this situation, the yin in the body still not weak. So in this situation, the patient have excess yang and yin. Why the patient may have excess yin or even normal yin? That's because of the relationship between yin and yang. When we studied the yin and yang theories at the beginning, we said that there are many yin and yang, they can mutually generate each other. So yin and yang can help each other. Yin and yang can generate each other. So excess yang can generate yin, which cause excess yin as well. And when these yang and yin, when they fight together, it will cause the pathological symptoms which belongs to yang, which means they will have fever or they are active. Such as the attitudes can refers to the activities, also can refers to the signs. So the characteristics of excess yang, the patient may have heat, also hot, heat, active, and dryness. So these are the characteristic of yang. Such as the fever, thirsty is kind of dryness. Face, red eyes, or yellow urine, constipation or dry stool, yellow coating, and speedy pulse. So this fast, and sometimes with heat, and active symptoms refers to yang. Excess yin in the process of the disease. In the development, the yin dominance, when the yin characteristics of coldness, quiet, and dampness, for instance, body can may feel cold, cold limbs, it lies like the boy in the picture. Voice, the pulse is low. So, as you can see the description from these symptoms, the symptoms of excess yang and the symptoms of excess yin, they actually reflect in different categories of yin and yang. That's why we gave them the definition of excess yin, and the title of excess yin. When we talk about the yin and yang here, we actually only focus on yin or yang, so either yin or yang. But in clinical practice, sometimes you can see they are combined together. Actually, the clinical patient from the clinics, we can see there is the combination of yin and yang. But when we study, we separate them, excess yin and excess yang. But when we talk about excess yin and yang, also you need to think about the excess and deficiency patterns that we have discussed in the previous video. Same as the habits that we when we study the theories, we always use the previous theories to explain or to be included in the theories we study later. So when we talk about yin and yang, the imbalance of yin and yang here, we need to think about what's the relationship between the yin and yang and the excess and deficiency patterns. So the excess yin and excess yang, if the patient have excess yang, which is dominant in the body, in this situation, if the yin is still strong, or if the patient have excess yin in the body, but the yang is still strong, in this situation, in the patient, when we see from the patient, the patient has excess yang and excess yin actually. So in this situation, we ring any bells that's from the excess and the deficiency patterns. The excess patterns means that the antipathogenic qi and pathogenic qi, when they fight violently, so they are very strong, they fight together, the adjective we use is strong, refers to the excess yang or the excess yin, depends on what kinds of pathogens but the body also strong. So the yin and yang, the excess yang can develop into excess yang patterns, excess yang heat patterns. The yin patterns can develop into excess yin cold patterns, because yin has the characteristic of coldness, yang has the characteristic of hot or heat. So that's the combination of these two, excess yang, excess yin. The next is relative deficiency of yin and yang. In this situation, the yin and yang in the body is weak. So that's why we said deficiency is weak. As you can see from the picture on the right side, when you see this tongue, and when you see this tongue, you can see the color, firstly, this one's red, this one's pale, and also these two, this one as well. So when you compare these two are pale, this one red. So this, the pale is yang deficiency, because the pale doesn't have enough heat. The red tongue is yin deficiency. And also you can see the tongue is cracking and dry on top. Compared with these two, it's moist, as you can see from the picture, it's shining. That's the saliva, the water on the tongue. So that's a moisture. So that's the characteristics of yang deficiency. Pale tongue. The patient can feel cold. So as you can see from this picture, the lady feel cold under the sun, but this gentleman feel hot. That's the yang deficiency. Yang deficiency means that the patient or the people, if it's not in sick situation, people have lack of heat in the body. That's why we call it yang deficiency. Or yang refers to hot or heat. So yang deficiency, the patient doesn't have enough yang, doesn't have enough heat. That's why have pale tongue, have fat tongue. So as you can see, this tongue is full of the mouth. And as you also you can see here, what's this? Why this tongue on the sides have these marks? But from here you also can see a little bit. It's true, right? Also here as well. But from this time, you see there's no smooth on the sides. What is the reason for this? We're going to study the tongue diagnosis in the next few weeks in the diagnostics. You will know that the teeth mark on the side of the tongue reflect the yang deficiency with dampness. That's the water retention or yang deficiency of the spleen. So these are the signs of yang deficiency. This patient may have for yang deficiency, for deficiency patterns. When we talk about excess yin or yang, or deficiency of yin or yang, we need to remember that these two belongs into the category of excess or deficiency, which we have studied in a previous video. So for the excess pattern, maybe you have the characteristics of the excess. Maybe you have the symptoms of the excess on the deficiency of yin and yang. You also have the characteristic of deficiency, which is weak or slow down. Weakness. So the yang deficiency can have the symptom of coldness, or the patient feel fatigue. And the yin deficiency, the patient may have not fever or mild fever. And then also can have the heat in the bones. They can feel the heat is from the bones, so very deep. The patient may be skinny or slim. The patient may have night sweat and also dry throat or with thirst. The red tongue, less coating, similar to the picture on the right side, and the pulse may be firm and fast. So these are the symptoms of yin deficiency. So for these patterns, you need to refer back to the textbooks, and also when we study the diagnostics, we're also going to discuss more in details. Also, these two, excess yin and yang, deficiency of yin and yang, has the trend of the organ, the zhang fu organs, because the essence, the innate essence, stores in the kidney. So in the essence stored in the kidney can separate into kidney yang and kidney yin, and kidney is considered as the source, the origin of the yin and yang of our whole body. So the yin and yang deficiency can happen in the kidney easily, and also the kidney will affect the spleen. That's why for deficiency, it happens in kidney. Also can be other organs. So these are the yin and yang. The impairments affecting yin and yang. On the picture, you also can see the teeth mark for this tongue. The yang impairments affecting yin, yin impairments affecting yang. So in this situation actually more common in our practice. This is because the yin and yang, they always together. So in this situation, the patient will have the symptoms or signs of both yin and yang, such as excess yang. Excess yang, such as excess heat, can affect yin. Excess fire in the body will consume the body fluids in the body, so it will cause the yin deficiency. You can see from excess yang causes yin deficiency. this young impairment affecting the yin, that's something. The relationship here actually is the relationship we talk in the yin yang theory. So the yang can affect yin, the yin also can affect the yang. That's from the also mutual independent mutual generation. The yang deficiency, the yin impairment affects the yang. In what situation we can see the yin impairment can affect the yang? Such as the patient has liver yin deficiency, and liver yin deficiency will cause heat, deficiency heat. Deficiency heat can affect the yang, the kidney yang. And in this situation, the patient may form yin deficiency and develop into aversion to coldness. So these symptoms, when we study the differentiations, we will have the full discussion of this, how they're going to affect each other, and why the patient will have all kinds of all these symptoms, and how do we understand these different symptoms in one patient, why the patient will feel cold in the hands or in the feet, in the foot of in the legs or feet. But in the meantime, the patient still feel hot, still have the hot feeling in their palms or under their soles. So this example, the patient feel cold in the hands, except the palms. And the patient feel cold in the feet, except under the sole. But in the palms and under the soles, the patient feel hot. Why they have these kinds of feelings? It's because of the yang deficiency and yin deficiency happens on the same patient. And the yang deficiency cause yin deficiency, or yin deficiency cause yang deficiency. That's because of the relationship between yin and yang. They can generate each other. If you don't have enough yang, you also be a lack of yin. That's the relatively relationship of these two. So if you confuse about this, you can go back to the yin yang theory and revise the relationship between these two. We didn't talk a lot of the relationship between these two. So you can revise them if you help you to understand better why yang can affect yin or yin can affect yang. It's because they can generate into each other. The repelling of yin and yang. SS yang repels yin, SS yin repelling yang. These two situations, we actually describe the situation that the patient have excess yang internally. So in the body, the patient have excess yang. The patient has too much yang in the body. And then in at this stage, the patient, the yin will reflect superficial. So the yin won't be able to go into the body. So all what we see from the superficial symptoms, you can see the yin symptoms, which have the characteristics of quiet or coldness or dampness. It says yin repels yang. It means in the body got excess yin, got too much yin in the body, and the yang is repelled at the superficial. So this patient have yin internally, and then we can see all the symptoms of yang symptoms, which reflect it hot, active, these kind of symptoms in the patient. So in clinic, what kinds of situation These tones, repelling of yin and yang, describes, for instance, if the patient a pale face and cold extremities, so the hands and the foot, the feet are cold, fatigue, aversion to cold, and very weak pulse. That's the due to excess yin internally. In the meantime, the patient have a red face, have fever, thirsty, and the pulse is big. So as you can see from here, the patient have all these opposite symptoms. They feel cold, but the patient have fever. The patient fatigue, feels tired, but the pulse is big. That's also opposite. The patient feel cold, but he feels thirsty. So these different symptoms, we need to distinguish which one is true, which one is false. So the excess yang, repelling yin, you also use the other term of true coldness. So true heat, false coldness. So this is very similar to the terms in SS and deficiency. We also have the terms of true or false. So here, SS yang, repelling yin, is the true cold, true hot with false coldness pattern. The SS yin, repelling yang, is the true coldness with false heat patterns. So that's the SS yin and yang. The SS yang, repelling yin, what kind of symptoms the patient may have? The patient may have fever, red face, and irritation, red tongue. The pulse may be fast and big and powerful. So from all these symptoms, you can see that's yang symptoms. Yang symptoms in the body, and then on the superficial, what we can see, the patient may have cold extremities. The pulse may be deep. So the pulse may be deep and powerful. Compared with superficial and deep, the deep pulse is yin. So we can see the yin symptoms, the yang heat, is called true coldness. Of with excess heat, with false heat. So have I make it wrong? The excess yang, repelling yin, is true heat with false coldness pattern. So the excess is the true, the one that repelling is false. Excess yin, repelling yang, is true yin, true coldness with false heat. And the symptoms of these two, the excess yang, repelling yin, is internally the patient will have the symptoms of yang and heat. But we also can see superficially, you can see coldness, the symptom of coldness. Okay. So that's the true heat with false coldness. The symptoms of excess yin, repelling yang, that's the true coldness with the false heat. But the patient may have internally coldness and manifests as the heat, is the false heat. The next, collapse of yin or yang, yang collapse or yin collapse. This is the very severe situation when we use acupuncture theories to describe this kind of situation. Yang collapse, that means we losing the yang dramatically. And in this situation, we actually don't have any yang in the body. When we don't have any yang in the body, then we will lose the function of yang, the yang qi. So when we talk about yang, if you confuse, you can add the qi there. So yang and yin refers to yang qi or yin qi. Then the function of yang qi, which is the womb, so you need to revise the function from the axons qi, blood body fluids. So from the discussion, we have mentioned the function of the qi, the yang qi function. Yang collapse, the patient will lose the function of yang qi. The function of yang qi, when the patient may feel cold, the patient may have sweat because the yang lost the function of controlling or confine the sweat. The patient may feel palpitation because the heart doesn't have yang to beat. May have pale face, cold extremities, and aversion to cold, fatigue, the pulse is weak. And in collapse, the patient may also sweat. The reason why the patient may have in collapse, the patient will sweat. That's because actually in collapse is it's through sweat. Sweat is one way of in collapse. There's no in, but why there's no in? Because excess sweating. The in collapse can also happen in excess yang because the heat consumes too much in. So in this situation, the patient may also sweat, irritate, palpitation, fatigue, fast pulse. And you can see these two when we talk about the symptoms of these two. Some of the symptoms are quite similar. These two kinds of symptoms, patterns, the patient can have the symptoms of sweating, palpitation, or pounding, pale face, fatigue. So these are the common symptoms of these two. But actually the sweat of these two, the signs of the sweating are different. So when we study the diagnostics, we will talk about what kind of sweat is considered as yang collapse, what kind of sweat is considered as yin collapse. This situation, these symptoms are actually the severe situation of our, in the clinic, it's the final stage of the disease. So the patient in very severe situation, the patient may pass away anytime from there. So we can see this kind of final stage, especially nowadays, it's not common for us to see in our outpatients. Mostly most of these patterns happens in the inpatients. So the one in the hospital, especially the one in the ICU wards, there you can see. Sometimes if you see the patient with palpitation or even coma, but some patients lay in the unconscious stage, so which is in unconscious, because the patient quiet, they don't move, those are in patterns. But in the meantime, sometimes you can see the patient's pumping. So from the breathing, that's young. So that's especially for the severe situation, the dangerous condition, we can see these kinds of extremely yin and yang patterns in one patient. So when you see these kinds of patterns, you will know how severe the disease is, and what's the development, what's the prognosis of the disease. So that's why we need to understand and study this theory of yin and yang. So that's the discussion of impairment of yin and yang. From this video, from this session of this discussion, we need to understand the symptoms of yin and yang and how they can develop into each other, how they can affect each other. So in order to study here, in order to understand the yin and yang impairments better, you can revise the theories of yin and yang. Then you will understand how they affect each other. And then in the next video, we're going to talk about the impairments of essence, qi, and blood. Thank you guys.